In this lesson, we will talk about how to rebase using Gitkraken Client, and we'll be focusing on the GUI side and how you can drag and drop a branch to trigger the rebase option and how you can use the context menu to trigger the rebase. Additionally, I should mention that rebasing can trigger conflicts. So it is possible that you might enter a scenario where you'll have to use that merge conflict editor or that merge tool that we were showing off in the merge lesson. So for this example, let's head over to this example repo. And I have a feature branch with three commits that I wish to rebase onto main. Now, similar to the merge video, you can drag and drop a branch onto a different branch in the graph to trigger actions that are available to you. So do you want to merge? Do you want to rebase? Or do you want to perform an interactive rebase? The interactive rebase, I will save for a separate lesson. But here it is. Here's the rebase feature onto main. I could go ahead and click it to get it to trigger the rebase to start. But before I do that, you can trigger a similar set of actions by dragging and dropping feature onto main here in local. So here it is, merge, rebase, interactive. And you could even get something similar if you drag and drop feature onto the remote version of main. So rebase, interactive. And I have a few other options as well. When in doubt, definitely stick to performing operations locally and then getting those changes onto your remotes if that's what you truly wish to do. Okay, so let's attempt to drag and drop feature onto main and perform a rebase. And I may have given myself away because I know that it's going to fail. So the rebase has failed because it has detected there are conflicts. Now, this one will be a little bit different than the merge conflict that we encountered in the merge video. And you'll see here that, like before though, I can select this top node to see all the conflicted files here in the top right of the commit panel. But when I click into this movie.md, I am not taken to the merge tool because it looks like what happened is that this file was modified on main but deleted on feature. So can't really see the side-by-side of a file that exists and one that's been deleted. So it's just asking, do you wish to delete this file as well? Do you wish to keep the modified version? What would you like me to do? So in this case, let's also delete this file. So I'll go ahead and match it. And then I'll click on this README file, and this will take me to the merge tool, much like we did in the merge lesson. I will choose to keep the changes on feature. A reminder that you can go through the different hunks of code. So I've selected B, so it has chosen all of the lines, but I can choose to mix and match. So if I wanted to keep this part of B, but this part of A, I can do that. And I can even type to make more changes. And you'll notice here we have some syntax, some nice editor features to make that a little easier. Okay, I'm gonna save it to mark it as resolved. And once you've resolved everything, you can go ahead and hit continue rebase. And this is how it would initially look if there were no conflicts. If there are no conflicts, this is exactly what you'll jump straight to. The three commits have been rebased onto main. We've effectively created three new commits and redrawn them onto main, and now they are rebased. Rebasing is handy if you wish to have a nice clean version history. You could also choose to squash commits before you rebase, but that's where interactive rebase might shine a little bit more. So there you go. That's how you can perform a rebase with Gitkraken Client. It's a great reminder that you can trigger conflicts when performing a rebase, but you can use Gitkraken Client's merge tool to resolve those conflicts and help your rebase sail right through. Otherwise, if you don't expect there to be any conflicts, your rebase will go through just as it did without needing to go use the merge tool.